Hello and welcome to New Frontiers on CCTV International. I'm Qi Xiaojun in Beijing. And today we're continuing with our major series about Chinese civilization. Way back in time, at the dawn of Chinese civilization, the allied forces of Huangdi, that's the Yellow Emperor, and Yandi defeated Chi You. Subsequently, a process began by which the various tribes scattered across Chinese territory merged, and this laid the foundation for the Chinese nation to develop. What followed was the Bronze Age, which coincided with China's Shang dynasty some 4,000 years ago. Now, the development of bronze smelting had a profound social impact. Communities became more settled around copper and tin mines, the two metals that form bronze alloy. Workshops were established where the bronze was fashioned into food vessels and into weapons of war.
The emergence of bronze smelting and bronze vessels marked the time in which China entered a great Bronze Age that was to last more than 1,500 years through the Xia, Shang, and Zhou dynasties. And it was in this period of world civilization that ancient China began to make great advances. The bronze vessels discovered in China are first in the world in terms of quantity and degree of exquisite craftsmanship. Also appearing in the Bronze Age are the oracle bone inscriptions of the Shang dynasty found in the Yin ruins. These oracle bone inscriptions mark the beginning of the time in China from which objects and era can be identified by characters. Around 4,000 years ago, there was a massive flood across the land of China, the first large-scale natural disaster to be recorded in the history of China. Many people were killed, others deprived of their homes. In the fight between people and nature, there appeared a great hero named Dayu, who led the people to harness the rivers and control the flooding, enabling the people to live and work in peace and contentment.
大禹的这个最根本的精神代表了中华民族的一种最根本的精神，就是一种依靠自己、自我牺牲而造福于别人的这样一种大爱的精神。比如说大禹吧，他就是当时这个洪水滔天的时候，别的民族的神话讲到洪水，多半是说某一个神给他什么指示，比如说挪亚方舟，他可以这个神告诉他大水要来了，然后他就造一个小船，然后他就躲在这个船里边。
Modern science has proved that at the end of the glacial period, there was indeed a worldwide flood on the Earth, and that it was caused.